Hi guys, this is Michael from Light Bicycle, and today I'm going to address a common question that we have, and that's how do I orient my asymmetric rims when I'm building them? So first off, what is an asymmetric rim? Compared to a standard rim where it's perfectly round, an asymmetric rim is, for lack of a better term, shifted off to one side. So what that does is it allows for more even spoke tension on the left and right sides. That results in a stiffer, stronger, and more reliable wheel build. So let's start with the rear wheel. If you were to imagine the hub on a rear wheel, you'll notice that the drivetrain side and the cassette takes up a lot of room, whereas the braking side only takes a little bit of room. So if you were to build that to a standard wheel, you'd be looking at a triangle where you have a more straight up and down spokes on the drive side, and you have longer spokes on the non-drive side. Switching over to an asymmetric rim, you'll notice that it's shifted over to the one side, so the spoke length is essentially shifted with it, meaning that you can have more even length spokes on the drive side and the non-drive side. That means when you're orienting your asymmetric rim on the rear wheel, the tall part of the rim, or the offset, should be closer to the non-drive side. So now let's talk about the front rim. When building with an asymmetric rim, the asymmetry is actually oriented the opposite on the front as it is the rear. This is because on the front rim, it's only the disc brake side that's taking up any extra room on the hub. So what that means is when you're orienting your front rim, the offset should be towards the non-disc side of the hub. Stronger, stiffer, more reliable. Those are the benefits of asymmetric rims, and I hope in the last couple minutes we've demonstrated why that is the case. For more tech tips videos like this, subscribe to our YouTube page, or if there's anything in particular you'd like to learn more about, leave it in the comment section below.